Fotslame is wrong when he claims that anarcho-capitalism is not a form of anarchy, and I will show that this is true even within his own flawed definitions. I will then show why those definitions are terrible. Fotslame has a few contradictory definitions of anarchism, but the general thrust of his concept is that anarchy has no rulers. This definition of anarchism includes anarcho-capitalism. ANCAPs do not disagree with a single modicum of this. But what about wage labour? Wage labour is not a scenario where one party rules another. A ruler is a person who imposes rules on someone, not one who works out a mutually beneficial and voluntary interaction with a person. And yes, every single voluntary trade is mutually beneficial, otherwise it would not occur as the losing party wouldn't consent. Ultimately, this comes down to a drastic misunderstanding of what anarcho-capitalism is. Rothbard coined the phrase to distinguish himself from the founder of anarchy, Proudhon, in that Rothbard was an Austrian economist and Proudhon was not. This is literally the only difference, what economic theory we hold. We do not detract ethically from Proudhon's anarchism in any way, shape or form. But Proudhon said property is theft. To cite this is to either be married to the concept that ANCAPs aren't anarchists, so much so that you discount the context, or to not have bothered to read the context. Proudhon was a Frenchman at a time when much of the land in Europe was under the possession of the aristocracy, who had not traded or homesteaded the property, but conquered it from peasants. This property certainly was theft. Proudhon makes this distinction explicit when replying to the French economist Jérôme-Adolphe Blanqui's criticism of his property is theft concept. Monsieur Blanqui recognizes that there are a mass of abuses, odious abuses in property. For myself, I call property exclusively the sum of those abuses. And again in 1841, distinguishing his beliefs from those of Pierre Leroux. Thus, according to Monsieur Leroux, there is property and property, the one good, the other bad. As it is proper to call different things by different names, if we keep the name property for the former, we must call the latter robbery, rapine, brigandine. If, on the contrary, we reserve the name property for the latter, we must designate the former by the term possession, or some other equivalent. Otherwise, we should be troubled with an odious synonymy. What makes Slime's citing of Proudhon extra amusing is the fact that Slime is in favour of direct democracy, and when Proudhon defined anarchy, he defined as being opposed to democracy. Neither hereditary nor election, nor universal suffrage, nor the excellence of the sovereign, nor the consecration of religion and of time can make royalty legitimate. Whatever form it takes, monarchistic, oligarchic, or democratic, royalty, or the government of man by man, is illegitimate and absurd. Before I get to Slime's horrific self-contradictions, I would ask that you hit the like button if you want to see more anarchist content from an economically literate perspective. So, in his anarchism Q&A, Slime says that anarchists oppose hierarchy, authority, and oppression, and later goes on to say that authority is only rejected where it does not prove itself to be necessary or beneficial. So ignoring the obvious contradiction there, he begs the question of how to know whether it's beneficial. Do we ask the authority, the people it rules, some third party? This is not made clear. He does add to this point later, saying that whatever authority exists should be mutually consensual and revocable at any time, which might as well have been written in the Ethics of Liberty. ANCAPs do not dispute this. At this point, I run into an issue of what his actual position on hierarchy is. In his ANCAPs aren't real anarchists video, he says that he's opposed to unjust hierarchy, but then debunks ANCAPism by pointing out that owning things and selling labor are hierarchies, but he doesn't show them to be unjust hierarchies. But if I assume he is against hierarchy qua hierarchy, and not only unjust hierarchy, then I am forced to ponder how exactly he thinks he can enforce that no hierarchies form without coercing anyone. After all, there are hierarchies present in any valued pursuit. Slime is higher in the YouTube hierarchy than me, Usain Bolt is higher in the running hierarchy than Slime, and Shroud is higher on the CSGO hierarchy than Bolt. Nowhere in these differences of dominance is it implied that anyone is coerced or ruled. And in case you are not yet convinced that Slime has yet to read a single piece of ANCAP literature, or even talk to an ANCAP, he erroneously states that the NAP is fine with slavery, and I have absolutely no idea where he could have conjured that from. What's more is he sets up a dichotomy between leftist anarchists and ANCAPs, on why they want the state gone, saying the leftists want it gone as it is a hierarchy that does not meet the burden of proof necessary to justify its existence. And assuming that burden is consent, then ANCAPs wholeheartedly agree with this. Slime instead says that ANCAPs want the state gone because it interferes with the market, showing an utter lack of knowledge of what the market is. The market is not some nebulous entity that one can infringe on in a vacuum. The market is just us, it's people interacting. To infringe on the market is to infringe on individuals. To top off his economic ineptitude, he makes the baseless wager that allowing property ownership means that such property will be accumulated in the hands of the few at the expense of everyone else. This relies on the false assumption that the market is a zero-sum game, but in fact, every market participant profits, and in allowing for a division of labour, you are able to most efficiently allocate scarce resources that otherwise would not be put to use. He also has a strange mask slip where he implies that ANCAPs are wrong in thinking that taxation is theft. If you think that the state has a right to tax people, and that this isn't theft, then I hate to break it to you, but you are a statist, by definition. And he keeps this thread of asserting that capitalism needs the state to function, without ever elaborating on why this would be the case. He kind of does whilst fading out at the end, where he says that the state needs to enforce private property to stop the working class from attacking it, which goes to show what socialists really think of working class people. I for one think the poors are fully capable of being peaceful individuals rather than being roving gangs of yobs. Now it is time to address the fabled "We are not anarchists" quote from Rothbard. This was written in an unpublished mid-1950s essay under the pseudonym of Aubrey Herbert. In the full context of the quote, Rothbard elaborates that he is simply saying we're not the left anarchists of that time who would destroy property, and similarly, we are not archists. To bridge this gap, he proposed that we call ourselves non-archists, but seemingly, after further reading into the origins of anarchy with Proudhon, Rothbard changed his mind, and you can find countless times where he calls himself an anarchist in his published writings that were not written just as he was beginning to understand anarchy.